Hello guys, today we're going to be reviewing the Mattel Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom Dimorphodon.
Yeah!
So let's get started with unboxing. Fresh out of the box is the Dimorphodon, yeah! Okay, let's get this out of the box. Man, this is nice looking. It's lots of maneuverability. Sort of playing around with it to see what it can do. Tail is like, it's not sort of rubber. At least, it doesn't feel rubber to me. Seems like a thin plastic, so you know it can bend it and stuff. Bend it. Wonder if you can position it. Legs move as one. You took the head. Yeah, you can. Sort of. Jaw's a little crooked. No ball joint. Paint job. Of course, as we expected. It's like a nice paint job with the eye. Nice single dot. Bit nicer on this side than this side. Get you more in the light. Back side, if you look at the back, it's all gray. There we go. That's better. You can see through it, but look at the bottom, you got these nicer wings. There you go, if you have the app in the water. Ah, there we go. There. Alright, so nice and black. It's like those specklings are black. Of course. We got that. There you go. We just need more light. It's a nice paint job, but simple. Just some red down here. Articulation is nice. There goes the tripod. This is my first Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom toy. You know, I think it's pretty good. That joint might wear out after a while. Hear a bunch of furious flapping. Sort of locks into place. Like, it locks into place when it's centered like this. You get a nice gliding look. Articulation's nice. Guess I'm repeating myself now. Well, before this gets too long, I'm gonna end here. See you later.
Yeah, hi. Yeah.